up with a little Marty Rapp.
No, I mean.
To a town of Iowa, 300 strange one fine day. Hardly spoke to folks around him and had much to say. No one dared to ask his business, no one dared make a step. But a stranger there among them had a big iron on his head. Big iron on his head. When he rode into the town, he came riding from the south side, slowly looking all around. He's an outlaw who's been running, came a whisper from his lip, and he's here to do some business with a big iron on his hip, a big iron on his hip. In this town they're living outlaw by the name of Texas. The stranger started talking, made it plain folks around. He was an Arizona ranger, wouldn't be too long in town. He came here to take an outlaw back alive or maybe dead, and he said it didn't matter, he was at the Texas Red. After Texas Red. Long before the story was relayed to Texas Red. But the outlaw didn't worry, men had tried before were dead. 20 men had tried to take him, 20 men had made a slip. 21 would be the ranger with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. Morning passed so quickly, it was time for them to meet. It was 20 past 11 when they walked out in the street. Folks were watching from the windows, everybody held their breath. They knew this handsome ranger was about to meet his death. About to meet his death. There was 40 feet between them when they stopped to make their play. And the swiftness of the rangers still talked about today. Texas Red had not seen letters for a bullet fairly writ. And the ranger's aim was deadly with the big iron on his hip. Big iron on his hip. It was over in a moment. The folks had gathered together. There before them lay the body of the outlaw on the ground. Oh, he might have went on living, but he made one fatal slip when he tried to match.